Now that I have my YouTube channel, I want to turn my videos into blog posts, but my original website isn't designed to do that easily, so I chose to use a website template instead. Here's what happened. Hi, I'm Elena, and on this channel I cover tech-related reviews and how-tos for entrepreneurs. If you want tech support for growing your business online, subscribe and ring the bell so you'll be notified of future videos like this one.
A website template is a pre-designed website that includes the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files. It'll often include multiple mockups of the homepage, about page, content page, and other common pages often found in websites. Their purpose is to help you to save time by not having to create something from scratch while still giving you full control over their contents, something you don't always have when you work with a builder. Website templates are a very common resource and you can find them almost everywhere. I already have an Envato Elements subscription for my YouTube channel, so that's the first place I went looking. Envato Market is already a popular place to get website templates, but Envato Elements selection is fairly substantial as well. I already had a design in mind, so I looked for a template that at least had the components I could use to piece together what I wanted. That template ended up being Juno. Here's the mockup of their main homepage. And here's the mockup of their blog post. Using a website template can be as simple as just replacing all of the written text and images that's seen in the browser, which means you could replace these images and this copy with your own. Even with limited experience, this task would be fairly easy to do because you just use the Find tool in your editor to locate the text you need to alter. And then find the folder where images are stored and start systematically replacing them with your own. For further customization, you can literally copy and paste the elements that you want from their different mockup pages to create a unique result. I took the hero section from their one-page design and placed it here so that visitors will know they're in the right place. Then, since my video articles are at the forefront of my website, they come next here. I then have an explanation of the different categories of articles here, and this element is taken from this mockup page. I copied in this parallax element as well. Something to keep in mind when it comes to using templates in general is that they're rarely optimized for SEO or conversions. Juno advertises being SEO ready, but there's definitely a lot more I'll need to do to fully optimize my site.
So what happened when I used a website template? If I were to write a website like this from scratch, it would probably take me 2 weeks of solid work at 40 hours per week. But by using a template, I was able to cut that time down to about 10 hours in total. Here's some tips I figured out along the way that made the process go along much smoother.
Not all website templates are created equal, so try and select one that is actively maintained by the developer. You can usually tell from the demo. And stay away from templates whose demos take a long time to load or don't work like they should. I think it's better to know what you need and have a design in mind before starting your hunt because it's pretty easy to get drawn off course with such a wide selection. If you have the opportunity, look at the files before committing and see if the site organization and hierarchy makes sense. Not only will good organization keep you sane while you customize your template, it'll also help with search engine optimization as website architecture affects SEO and bots use hierarchy to crawl your site. So if you find poor organization in the files, you should probably stay away. Work with a copy and don't alter the original files. This way you always have your original starting point and can also easily add to your site if the need arises. Start with your auxiliary pages first. In my case, that would be all of my video articles and my privacy and terms pages. That way you can work towards your homepage and already have page names and links ready for customizing your homepage, which should provide a clear path to all pages on your website. And finally, check your links. Most templates have a lot of links that go to mockup pages that you might not end up using. You'll either need to rename the link and replace the mockup page or remove the section entirely before publishing your website. I'm fairly certain I caught all unused links in my new website, but I'll use a broken link checker as soon as I publish to be sure.
If you'd like a walkthrough of that process, let me know in the comments. Until next time, be happy, be healthy, and always be building. Thanks so much for watching.